we plant our plantations at a dense spacing, figuring that some of the trees are going to die. But as they grow, they get really crowded. And so we need to thin them out so that the best trees will continue to grow, and the less healthy trees, ones that are deformed, we cut those out, and we're looking at saving the best and fastest growing trees for the future.
A typical unit when we start one is pretty, it's pretty dense in there, you know. I mean, the trees are planted really close together when you start out, and that's why they got to have us come in there and thin them so that they can get sunlight in. You can see the benefits as soon as you do it, the trees that you're leaving are getting more sunlight, and you know that's good for them, and they're just growing better, and they're not having to compete, you know, with the other trees so close, and it just makes for a good, healthier tree. And the trees that were actually falling down, they sit there and rot on the ground and just go right back into the soils.
The tribe depends on the revenue from its timber harvest. And if the trees don't grow the way we expect them to grow, if they're too crowded, then we won't get the size trees that we want. We won't get the future revenue that we expect to get from the forest. Having a healthy, well-growing forest is essential to that.
When you first see a unit logged, you know, it doesn't look so good, but man, once you get it planted again and we come in there and start doing our job, it really makes you feel good that you're giving back to the forest. It's just a nice cycle that's going to keep the forest here for all generations, you know.
The EQIP program from NRCS has been really a godsend. Without some of the money from the EQIP program to do pre-commercial thinning, some of these stands wouldn't get thinned. We just don't have the funding to do all the stands. And so our relationship with the local NRCS has been great. We're on our third contract now for pre-commercial thinning, and it's been going along great.
Oftentimes our tribes have not had the financial resources nor the technical resources that they need to reach their tribal goals. But they often have cultural resource goals as well on these lands, and may use those lands for hunting and gathering for tribal members. So it goes beyond the typical work that NRCS might do to help them meet those cultural resource goals as well. I believe NRCS staff in Oregon really goes out of their way to try to engage the tribes. And I'm very proud of the type of planning we're able to do that specifically serve the tribal needs in the way that our tribes want to work.